I speak as a perspective of a Muslim, as a Muslim who's visited Israel and Palestine on a number of occasions, who's seen the challenges which exist, the anxieties which occur on a day-to-day basis, irrespective of which side you are on. But I'm also one in my role as someone who is now responsible as part of Eric's team for faith engagement and community engagement to accentuate the positives of what you see, how communities in Israel and Palestine come together, the people who want to see peace for the right reasons, who want to see, yes, as we talked before about a secure and stable Israel, but also a viable Palestinian state. But you know, ladies and gentlemen, it should be more than that. It should be two states, independent, yes, but also interdependent. Is it not our great country that when we see our parliament, which shows people from all backgrounds, social backgrounds, economic backgrounds, and indeed, as we heard in our introduction, religious backgrounds, coming forward across the board, excelling in every field, every facet of life, because our country is an incredible example of not just tolerance, but of understanding and mutual respect. Irrespective of our differences and irrespective of who we are, where we came from, what faith we follow, ultimately we can come together for the common good, about the shared values we have. And there's a lot that's said about that, but it is important that we reflect upon them. I was once attending an event of my own community where a Christian gentleman asked the head of the community, "Sir, you are a Muslim, you think Islam is right and Christianity is wrong." He smiled and he said, "What gave you that notion?" He said, "Far from it. I don't believe any religion is wrong. At its inception, every religion, no matter what name you give it, comes from the same single being." And then he smiled and he said, "Tell me, do you know what the M25 is?" Now you can imagine a religious gathering and someone, suddenly a religious leader all sort of dressed accordingly, talking about the M25. The person asking the question said, "Yes, sir, it's a motorway." He said, "Yes, it's an orbital motorway around London." And he said, "Indeed it is." To which he said, "Now tell me, do you know what the M1 is?" He said, "Yes, sir." "So, well, tell me." He said, "It's a motorway which runs from London to Yorkshire." He said, "Okay. Now tell me, what is the A1M? He said, "Sir, that's also a route one can undertake to go from London to Yorkshire." And so the conversation, or the question, continued. He said, "Tell me about the B roads, the country roads. Do you understand what I'm saying?" he asked. To which the questioner responded, "I do, sir. Our start point and our end point is the same." To which the Imam responded by saying, "You know what? You're quite right. And that's what religion is. That ultimately our start point and end point is exactly the same. And whatever route you take, now as a Muslim I may well feel I'm on the fast route, I'm on the fast track on the M1. A Christian may feel they are the M1 and I'm on the B road. Now, irrespective of where I am or what route I'm undertaking, the destination and the start point is the same. And religion is but a route we undertake in ensuring those common values we share. Whether it's the Near Neighbours Project run by the Church of England, whether it's the Mitzvah Day initiative, which I myself actively participated in only last week at my local synagogue, or it's the Big Iftar run by the Muslim community, which again, the department is happy to support. These are all, ladies and gentlemen, demonstrable examples how faith communities are not a problem, as some would perceive them, and we've got to stand up and be strong and vocal about that. We need to be demonstrably be able to say faith communities are part of the solution. And we in Britain are a practical, live, working, dynamic example of who we are and what we are. Yes, different by our backgrounds, our culture, our religions, but united in the common things we share about the incredible country that we are part of. But if I may just finally read out the Prime Minister's message. And he says, and I quote, "I welcome the Jewish News New Interfaith section, which will no doubt highlight the fantastic work of thousands of dedicated people and groups around the country who help bring communities and faiths closer together. At a time when we hear so much about conflict and violence between different religions across the world, it is important not to overlook the incredibly positive things that go on every day at home and indeed abroad to unite them. These actions, born out of kindness and generosity, are often carried out by faith and voluntary organisations who are motivated by nothing other than wanting to help their fellow man or woman and help create a better place. It is part of what I call the big society, and is something British people have been doing for generations. I'm sure the new interfaith section, in partnership with the brilliant Pierce Foundation, will help bring these inspirational stories to life for many thousands of Jewish News online readers. That was a message from the Right Honourable David Cameron, the Prime Minister. Ladies and gentlemen, it's a pleasure to be here with you this evening. I wish this new initiative well, and thank you for listening to me, and I look forward to working with both the Jewish News, indeed all of you, as we go forward to building the stronger, diverse, yes, but very much united nation that we all aspire to be part of. Thank you.